Bernard Dumble, a tenant residing in Donholm, says that the desperate search for a house in the city has led many like him to sign expensive contracts that they are unable to shoulder, especially with the current economic climate, which is locking majority of Kenyans out of decent housing.
It's a big issue. Housing is a big issue.
David Keogh, another tenant that lives in Donholm, says that landlords are quick to cash in on their investments, are slapping tenants with impromptu hikes without consulting them. And wherever there's a delay in rent payment, they incur a hefty fine.
Like, seriously, I was late to pay my rent with some reasons. And automatically, the landlord, he doesn't care what you're doing. Ile kitu tu unafaa, kitu ya kwanza before hata umpigie simu. If it's on date 5th, which is the deadline for paying rent, would you pay your charges at 10%?
If you're struggling to pay your rent, are you willing to take up the legal challenge to pursue your grievances in a court of law? Maybe not. If you have got problems paying your rent, you need to think twice about taking it up.
Despite the existence of law which protects the rights of tenants against oppressive landlords, many tenants are not aware of the Rent Restriction Tribunal, which adjudicates over rent disputes not exceeding 2,500. The tribunal has the mandate to oversee implementation and ensure enforcement of the rent restriction laws by protecting the rights and obligations of both the tenants and the landlords. But quite often, most tenants are left at the mercy of landlords due to the acute shortage of housing in the country.
But if we go the way we have capped interest rates, it can still work. Because landlords have taken advantage to exploit the shortage of housing, to exploit tenants.
In most low-income settlements, tenants are often exploited by landlords who levy unjustified service charges for shared services.
Because you find you're sharing a water meter and all of you, for some reason, you've got to divide in terms of the units. But then when you ask the occupants of the units, then the consumption is varied. It's a question whether you're paying for what you use.
According to the provisions of the Rent Restriction Tribunal, any landlord who exceeds the standard rate shall be guilty of an offence and will be liable to a fine not exceeding 4,000 Kenyan shillings or imprisonment for a term not exceeding 6 months or both. Under the law, a tenant is entitled to a peaceful occupation of his tenancy house and is not subject to eviction unless the landlord has obtained authority from the tribunal.
It is easier to read the law like it is, but we talked that to a person who wants to have a night, an additional night in a place that belongs to another person, until it becomes a personal negotiation.
According to the Secretary General of Urban Tenants Association of Kenya, Ephraim Murigo, many tenants are ignorant of their rights, making them vulnerable to be exploited by landlords.
There's no landlord who is supposed to lock your house. When you don't pay your house genuinely, there is a procedure that the landlord needs to follow.
On their part, tenants have blamed the government for looking the other way as landlords continue to charge exorbitant rents, eating up a substantial part of their hard-earned income.
Because these ancillary items are very costly. By the time you bring power, water, and the roads, and the sewage, it is almost 40% of the cost of the building.
Despite the existence of law protecting their rights, tenants still find themselves helpless in fighting against oppressive landlords.
Those who do not act are driven by fear. What will happen? The landlord has got money, most probably, and I don't. What will happen if I sue a guy who has money? And we know what happens in Kenya if you do not have and somebody has.
More and more Kenyans have an appetite to own a home, a place they can call their own. But with landlords coming every month to knock at your door to ask for rent, and sometimes tenants being stubborn and delaying to pay rent, both tenants and landlords should coexist and make it easy for each other. Sarah Adam, K24.